Have you ever wanted to do that thing with text? Where it sticks to someone or something in a shot and follows them wherever they go?
Well, here's how you do it, the DaVinci Resolve.
There's a whole bunch of different ways that you can track text in DaVinci Resolve, but the method I'm going to show you today is a simple translation method, which means I need to track my movement across this shot and then attach the text to that movement, which thankfully sounds a lot harder than it actually is. So first I'm going to right click this clip here and go to New Fusion Clip, because we're going to use Fusion to do this. I'll then hop into the Fusion tab. In Fusion, in the Nodes section, we'll see a Media In node. And this is our video clip going into the media out. We're going to come up to the effects tab and search for tracker. So you'll see a few here like the planar tracker and the camera tracker, but the one we want is just the simple tracker here. So I'm going to drag this in between our clip and the media out. So we're feeding our video clip into the yellow input. And with that node selected, you're going to see a bunch of things appear. You see this little tracker in our viewing window, as well as a bunch of confusing controls in the inspector window too. Now thankfully we only need to use a couple of these controls, but before we take a look at them, I'm going to drag our playhead back to the start of the clip, because I want to track this clip from start to finish, so we're going to start here. If you then hover your cursor over this tracker, you'll see we have two boxes. The one on the inside with the cross is going to track whatever image we place it on. So if I place it here, it will be looking for this image. And the one on the outside is the area we want the tracker to look for that image within. So the inside is what it's looking for, and the outside is where it's looking. And you can click on the edges of these just to make the boxes bigger or smaller, depending on what you need. I'm then going to click on this little square in the corner here, and that'll move the tracker to a position where I think it's going to be good to track. And this is usually where a lot of people mess up with this process. It may seem obvious, but if you've ever tried to use a tracker before and it didn't work for you, this is probably why. The tracker needs something specific to follow, and it can be whatever you want, but it has to be something unique and identifiable in the shot.
So this is kind of why I wore my red jacket, because it's really colourful and it's going to be easy to pick out in a place like this. Basically, you want something like a logo or something that's going to be high contrast, that's going to make it really, really easy for your tracker to latch onto. You don't want to use a pattern or something that's replicated across the whole frame, because then it's going to be really difficult for your tracker to differentiate between that and something else.
So with that in mind, I'm going to move the tracker to this spot here on my shoulder. This is a pretty consistent image throughout the shot. It's also pretty unique because you have my bag behind it, the strap in front of it, and the hood above. So it's hard to confuse this area with somewhere else. With that selected, we're going to come up to our tracker in the inspector window and hit this icon here, which is going to start working through our clip from start to finish. It may take a minute or two to complete depending on your footage, but you could follow it along frame by frame as it does its thing. Now, in this instance, it's been really successful. You can see the path here that it's tracked, but it might not always work out this well. So if it does go off track, here's a couple of things you can do to fix it. First of all, you can try adjusting the size of the tracker window. Part of the reason this one worked out so well is because the tracker windows were set to the right size. But if I was to start this again and make this really small, like this, you'll see that, yeah, that just doesn't work well because the area is way too small. There's no way to differentiate the tracker point against anything else. So just starting again and adjusting this to be bigger or smaller, depending on what you're tracking, can be helpful. You can update each point manually too though. So if you're in a situation where it's tracked pretty good for most of the shot, but it just goes off course for a few frames at the end, you can then jump to the point where it goes off and move the tracker back to the right position. You can then do that for each frame for the rest of the shot if you want to, or alternatively, you can hit this button here, which will then make an attempt to track it again from the point that you're at to the end. Doesn't always work, and it can be a bit of trial and error, but once you're happy that you've tracked the shot right, it's now time to add in your text. So even though we've tracked this, we've not told our tracker what to do with that information yet. So in the inspector window, you're going to jump over to the operation tab and change the operation from none to match move. Below that, just make sure the merge is also set to foreground over background. With that done, that'll ensure that whatever we feed into the green foreground input of this tracker will take the tracked information and match the movement of it. So I'm going to grab a text plus node here and feed this into our tracker. I'll then put in some text and play it back. And as you can see, we've got some tracked text. I'm not 100% happy with where it is though, so from the layout section of the text node, I can control where the text is relative to the point that it's tracking. And there you go, you've tracked some text. But this method can actually do a lot more, because you can pretty much feed anything into this tracker now and it'll follow that path. You can add an arrow, you can add some text animations, whatever you please. If you want to learn more cool stuff in DaVinci Resolve, why not give this video a try? Or this one. Or hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.